Hello.
Damn, it's been a while.
It is fascinating, Jeff Zeleny, to see what I'll call the range of Trump, if you will. He has been more in command of the facts in these recent briefings. At the very end of the briefing, he talked about Americans who are feeling isolated right now, in addition to the pandemic, in addition to the economic stress, maybe having depression or mental health issues. He said, I love you, we are with you, we will support you. You get that from the president, but then you get that. His anger at China, leading into, he's almost deliberately using the term in his tweets and in the briefing as if to poke, but some people take great offense.
He absolutely is using that, and I think it is a huge range of the president and a vast difference from the president we saw yesterday. You want to hear from the president and leadership, but the never mind the stock market, which was falling during all of that, but the range of information. But I do think it's important to separate the politics from this, of him saying he didn't have advance notice of this other thing, to look at really focus on the very important information we learned in the country. And I think as the doctor was saying, the younger people in France and Italy may be getting sicker than we think. And it was essentially the administration saying, wake up, America. This is getting worse here. Don't panic because of the increase in curves. So we almost have to, at least for the moment, to set the president's words aside about the Chinese virus and focus on the issues. And boy, were there a lot of headlines.
Right. It gets to the point that Dr. Murthy was making about trust. The president himself could shut those things down by saying that's not what we're going to focus on. But to that point, Dr. Murthy saying we cannot have the large gatherings that continue to occur. It's that continue to occur part that is so striking. Essentially, her appealing from the White House, people, you're not listening to us. You are not listening to us. You must stop. Karen, diversion, I want to bring you into the conversation. You heard Julia Chatterley. We talked earlier before the briefing started about the urgency here in Washington. The president himself agreed when he was asked, do you feel like you're a wartime president right now, on a wartime footing? What do we expect as the administration keeps moving the number up? Do we expect the Senate will be able to reach an agreement today on what would be called phase 3, knowing there's going to be a phase 4, a phase 5, and a phase 6 and more?
I think that's the big question. I mean, we're looking to see if the senators can really put what have been party ideologies aside at this point to come to an agreement on this number, which, as you stressed, is going up, up, up. I think you still have some people who are in the body who are finding difficulty doing that, saying that, look, you know, how can we keep throwing money at this one?